Alright, hello students, how are you feeling today? Okay, this is subject SS standard 9. I have already started chapter number 15 called drainage system, right? This is the third video for this chapter, drainage system. Do you remember, my dear students, in the first video I explained the common information, river basin, water divide and all and so on, right? In a second video, I explained there are three rivers of main major rivers of Himalaya, Brahmaputra, Ganga and Sindhu. So in the previous video, I discussed about Sindhu river system. Do you remember? I discussed about Sindhu river system, right? And I told you the meaning of river system. That is, any river flows along with its tributaries called river system. So today I am going to explain Ganga river system. Let us start. Now see, Ganga river originates from Gangotri. That is in Uttarakhand. See, I will go step by step, you focus. It is not that much complicated, just focus. Ganga river originates from Gangotri, that is in Uttarakhand. From Gangotri, two river originates. It is not known as Ganga from Gangotri. Let me tell you very clearly. From Gangotri, whichever river just flows, not at all known as Ganga. Let me tell you. From Gangotri in Uttarakhand, two river originates. One is called Bhagirathi and second is called Alaknanda. See, from Gangotri two river originates. One is called Bhagirathi and second is called Alaknanda. Now, both the rivers, when they are flowing from Gangotri, they merge into one place. Called Devprayag. See, when they merge into one place called Devprayag, that is also in Uttarakhand. See, from Gangotri, two river originates, Bhagirathi and Alaknanda. Both the river mixes and merges into one at Devprayag, that is in Uttarakhand. From Devprayag, it is known as Ganga. See, as I told you, from beginning Gangotri, it is not known as Ganga. Two rivers, two into one at Devprayag in Uttarakhand. And thereafter Devprayag in Uttarakhand, it starts flowing. Then it is known as Ganga, right? After Devprayag, then Ganga leaves mountain region. Means from Himalaya, from Gangotri, when it flows, then after it leaves mountain region and enters in Haridwar. Now, my dear students, Haridwar, you are very well familiar, right? Thousands of people go every day, that is called Harki Podi, right? People go to Harki Podi to take bath and to take the darshan of Ganga river, and that is called Haridwar. So, from Devprayag, it leaves mountain region and then come on a single plane, that is called Haridwar. Which is that place? Haridwar. And when it is flowing in Haridwar, here three tributaries meet to Ganga river. Where? Haridwar, right? Let me write here the name of the three rivers that meet to Ganga river. I will explain through map. You will come to know easily that from where it starts, which two river merges into one where, then after flowing in which position how. So Devprayag, then known as Ganga, then leaves mountain region, come on a single plain at Haridwar, and three tributaries meet at Haridwar with Ganga. First one is Ghagra, second one is Gandak, and third one is Kosi. See, these three rivers meet with Ganga where? At Haridwar with Ganga, right? So these rivers meet with Ganga, these three tributaries. See, the destination of any river, one river, tributaries, then merge, and then flow of water, and then going another tributaries meet. See the situation, right? We have not imagined before reading this. After three tributaries, from right side, Yamuna river comes from right side of Ganga. Yamuna river flows that originates from Yamunotri. Yamuna river originates from Yamunotri. Ganga river originates from Gangotri, but it is not known as Ganga from Gangotri, as I told you, Bhagirathi and Alaknanda. Same way, Yamuna river originates from Yamunotri, from right side, and for example, this is Yamuna, and this is the Ganga, right, Haridwar. Those three tributaries meet. After that, Yamuna comes from right side, and Ganga comes, they both meet in one place. They both meet in one place at Allahabad. See, Ganga river and Yamuna river, one from Gangotri and one from Yamunotri, both from Uttarakhand. See, both from Uttarakhand, and they both meet into one place called Allahabad. What is that word? Allahabad. Now, from here major turn starts. From here, major turn start, because when Allahabad, when both river merges into one and flowing very fast with speed, Allahabad, then we will have two branches. Then we will have two branches. One flow of Ganga river will go at West Bengal. See, one flow of Ganga river will go to West Bengal, and another flow will go to Bangladesh. See, another flow will go to Bangladesh. What is the meaning? It means Ganga river leaves India and going in the country called Bangladesh, right? Where from Allahabad there will be two branches. One part will go in West Bengal and one part will go in Bangladesh. Now, let me tell you one thing, that if another river will come into one, that is called tributaries. But see, Allahabad, Ganga river, from Ganga two river pass, means from that river two river emerges, that is called distributaries. What is that called? Distributaries means DIS, we need to write opposite one, right? So from Allahabad two branches, one branch will go in West Bengal and one branch will go in Bangladesh. Now see, everywhere name of the river will be different, tributaries name will be different. So when Ganga river will flow in Bangladesh, it is known as Padma. See, name of the river will be changed. When Ganga river will go in Bangladesh, it is known as Padma, and when Ganga river will go in West Bengal, it is known as Bhagirathi Hugli. See, Bhagirathi Hugli. We see different name. One river, same water, but when it will go in different country, different state, different part, then name of the river will be changed, right? Let me repeat. From Allahabad, there will be two parts. One part will go in West Bengal, another part will go in Bangladesh. When Ganga river will go in Bangladesh, it is known as Padma. Same way, when Ganga river will go in West Bengal, it is known as Bhagirathi Hugli. it is known as Bhagirathi Hugli, right? Then both side, both water will go at last in way of Bengal. When it is goes in way of Bengal, see the destination. See the destination. Originates from Gangotri, meet with tributaries, distributaries. At last, both the rivers, including Yamuna, including Ghagra, Gandak, Koshi, another tributaries, all mixes into one. Too much overflow and mixes with Bay of Bengal. Here ends the destination of Ganga from Gangotri to Bay of Bengal. Right? Here ends. Now, I will explain through map, so no problem. You will come to know easily. This I have given general information about Ganga River, from where it originates, where it goes, which are the main religious places of Ganga River, and then the destination Bay of Bengal. Let me give common information about Ganga. Then we will see through map. Let me just give through map afterwards. Now, the length of Ganga River is 2,500 kilometer long. See, Sindhu River, what is the length? Do you remember? 2,900. But the length of Ganga River, 2,500 kilometer. Means Sindhu River is longer than Ganga River, right now? Alright. Then after, in Ganga River, when it meets to Bay of Bengal, the Ganga River plus Brahmaputra River, both they mix. See, for example, Ganga River goes in Bangladesh, same way Brahmaputra River also will come in Bangladesh. That I will explain in detail when I will explain Brahmaputra River system. But just giving you overview. Ganga River will come in Bangladesh. Brahmaputra River will come in Bangladesh. See, they both will come in Bangladesh. This is known as, now it is not known as Ganga. It is not known as Padma. It is not known as Brahmaputra. It is known as Meghna. Which river? Meghna. See, the mixture of Ganga River and Brahmaputra River, when they merge into one in Bangladesh, in another country out of India, it is known as Meghna. What is known as Meghna? Now, see, Ganga River and Brahmaputra River, when they meet to Bay of Bengal, they make very fertile land called delta. See, they make very fertile land called delta, and that is known as Sundarban. Do you remember I told you, right? When I gave common information in the first video. So, in Ganga River and Brahmaputra River, though it is in Bangladesh, it is extended to India. It is extended to India because it is very big. So this is known as Sundarban. Why Sundarban? Because Sundri trees are there. Which trees are there? Sundri trees are grown in Sundarban. That's why it is known as Sundarban. And let me tell you common information. Sundri trees are under the water. Means up to stem of the tree, water, and then everywhere you will find water. Why? Because of the Ganga River overflow, because of flood sometimes, you will find Sundri rivers, trees will be under water, right? That's why they are known as Sundarban. And the last one is Ambala Peak. See, Ambala Peak, it is Ambala City also. So this works as water divide. Do you remember I explained water divide means? Right? Sindhu River, as I told you like that. Sindhu River. Then here Ambala peaks are there. And then here Ganga River. See, here Ganga River, here Sindhu River. So, this Ambala peak works as water divide. Means Sindhu River flowing here, Ganga River flowing here. So Ambala city or Ambala peaks works as water divide. Works as water divide. So my dear students, I hope you have understood the common information about Ganga, Ambala city as a water divide between Sindhu river and Ganga river, Delta, Sundarban and Sundri trees. Then from where Ganga river originates and where it meets to Bay of Bengal. And which rivers in between meet, tributaries, Yamuna and all, let's understand through map. Then I will talk about that. I will explain through map which river flows from where and where it meets. Let's. Okay, so see, I give the common information about whole Ganga river system. Now let's understand through map where it flows, where it goes. Now, as I told you, see, this is Uttarakhand. This is Uttarakhand, and here there is a Gangotri place. See, here there is a Gangotri place. Here Alaknanda and Bhagirathi originates. See, I have just drawn Uttarakhand, Gangotri. This is two river, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi. Then after here they meet Devprayag, known as Ganga. Now it is known as Ganga. From here it goes ahead. See, from Nepal, three river tributaries meet. There I told you that the Ghagra, Gandak and Kosi, there are three tributaries. They come from Nepal. They come from Nepal. See a little, Nepal, right? They come from Nepal. So from here, Gangotri, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi. Then Devprayag, known as Ganga. Then moves forward in Haridwar, on a plain. Then on a plain, three rivers meet from Nepal. Ghagra, Gandak and Koshi. Then moves further, so you can see the schedule, right? Moves further, then one part goes in Pashchim Bengal, means west of Bengal, and one part goes in Bangladesh. Two branches I told you now. From Allahabad, then after West Bengal, one branch will go in West Bengal, and one branch will go in Bangladesh. When it will go in Bangladesh, it is known as Padma. And when it goes in West Bengal, it is known as Bhagirathi Hugli, right? That I told you. So here it is known as Bhagirathi Hugli, and here it is known as Padma, Bangladesh Padma, and West Bengal Bhagirathi Hugli. Now, both rivers, the last destination is Bay of Bengal. Both rivers, last destination is Bay of Bengal. So this is the journey of Ganga river. See. Sindhu river, do you remember that from here it goes, right? So see, here there is a Ambala place, water river. See, here Ambala peaks, so Sindhu river flows here and Ganga river flows here. There is a water divide between two. Sindhu river cannot come this side and Ganga river cannot go that side because of Ambala water peak. Understood? This is Sindhu river, I explained. Now Ganga river, Gangotri, Devprayag, then after moves, three tributaries meet at Nepal, then going further, Allahabad, then going further, one part in Bangladesh and another part in West Bengal. And West Bengal known as Bhagirathi Hugli, and in Bangladesh it is known as Padma. Here then meets to Bay of Bengal. This is the journey of Ganga river system. See, 2500 kilometer long. Now through this map only I am going to explain third number river system, that is Brahmaputra river system. Brahmaputra river system, see, I will explain, I will write. So Brahmaputra river system, see, let me start first. Brahmaputra river is longer than Sindhu river and Ganga river. Let me repeat. Brahmaputra river is longer than Sindhu river and Ganga river, because though 2900 kilometer, but it is Brahmaputra is longer than Sindhu river and Ganga river. Means out of three, Brahmaputra is longest. Out of three, I am not saying overall. Out of three, Brahmaputra is longest out of three. Then after, see, Putra. Only this river has masculine gender. ब्रह्मपुत्र. एनी रिवर से गंगा यू कैन फाइंड फेमिनाइन, देन यमुना जमुना राइट, ऑल द रिवर नर्मदा तापी दे हैव फेमिनाइन नेम्स, बट ओनली ब्रह्मपुत्र द वन वर्ड पुत्र शोज मैस्कुलाइन जेंडर. व्हाट इज दैट शोज मैस्कुलाइन जेंडर बिकॉज पुत्र इज गिवन राइट. नाउ लेट्स सी द जर्नी ऑफ ब्रह्मपुत्र थ्रू मैप ऑल्सो एंड आई विल राइट हियर ऑल्सो. लेट्स सी from where it starts and where it goes like Ganga river. See the destination of Brahmaputra. Let me start. See now Brahmaputra river once again originates from Tibet in Gujarat, we say Tibet or whatever. So see it originates from Tibet. Let me write originates from Tibet. Same like Sindhu river, you know Sindhu river originates from Tibet, Mansarovar lake and going further that I have seen right, I have drawn. Same way from here Mansarovar lake that Brahmaputra river originates, again Mansarovar lake. See in Sindhu river originates from Tibet and Mansarovar lake going this way, and Brahmaputra river also originates from Tibet, Mansarovar lake and going further in China. See, most of the part of the river flows in China. I am telling you comparison. Sindhu river most of in Pakistan, Brahmaputra river mostly in China, only some part in India, only some part in India. So when it originates from Mansarovar lake, goes in China, where it is known as Tsenpo. See, right now it is not known as Brahmaputra. Like Gangotri, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi, it is not known as Ganga. Same way, in China, Brahmaputra is known as Tsenpo. It is known as Tsenpo in China. Here, see, when it originates in China, it is known as Tsenpo. Everywhere mountains are there, cannot find a place where to go. Which river? Tsenpo will be known as Brahmaputra. So Tsenpo cannot find a place because of mountains. Then here there is one mountain called Namcha Barwa. Namcha Barwa. See, this is a mountain. Here Brahmaputra takes U-turn. See, everywhere mountain, Brahmaputra river, Tsenpo river cannot find a place how to go downside. So here there is a mountain called Namcha Barwa. Here it takes U-turn and enters in Arunachal Pradesh. This river enters in Arunachal Pradesh by taking U-turn, right? By taking U-turn, it enters, by taking U-turn of Namcha Barwa, it enters in Arunachal Pradesh. See, if you go by step by step, you will remember. Otherwise, you will feel confused. Which river is known as where it will go, with whom it will meet. Don't be confused, my dear students. Go step by step. See, Sindhu river, how simply Ganga river. Same way, Brahmaputra river also very simple. So after mountain, taking U-turn at Namcha Barwa, going in Arunachal Pradesh. In Arunachal Pradesh, again from Tsenpo to, it is known as Dihang. See, in China it is known as Tsenpo. When it enters in India, Arunachal Pradesh, it is known as Dihang. Then after it enters in Assam. After Arunachal Pradesh, it enters in Assam. See, moves further, enters in Arunachal Pradesh, known as Dihang, then enters in Assam. Here it is known as Brahmaputra. See, here when it enters in Assam, after Arunachal Pradesh, this river is known as Brahmaputra. Which, it can be asked in short question, that Brahmaputra river is known as in which state of India? Assam. Where? Assam. and Dihang in Arunachal Pradesh. Dihang in Arunachal Pradesh. Now, here journey doesn't end. When it enters in Assam, known as Brahmaputra, then after, again it enters in Bangladesh. See, let me show you here. When it enters in Assam, then it enters in Bangladesh. See, Ganga River also enters in Bangladesh, known as Padma. And when Brahmaputra River through Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, when it enters in Bangladesh, then it is known as Yamuna. See, one river different names. See, one river different names. So when Brahmaputra enters in Bangladesh, then it is known as Yamuna, like this. Here it is Padma and it is Yamuna, right? Because both enters. Ganga River enters in Bangladesh and Brahmaputra River enters in Bangladesh. Ganga River known as Padma and Brahmaputra River known as Yamuna. But when Padma River and Yamuna River, means Ganga River and Brahmaputra, don't be confused. Ganga River enters in Bangladesh known as Padma. Brahmaputra River enters in Bangladesh known as Yamuna. So Padma and Yamuna, it means Ganga and Brahmaputra, when they meet in Bangladesh, it is known as Meghna. Which river it is known as? Meghna. The mixture of Ganga River and Brahmaputra River, it is known as Meghna. See, one river, different names. Different state, different country, right? So it is known as Meghna. Now, as I told you that masculine gender, 2,900 km long, Bangladesh Yamuna, and both river mixes and Meghna, and at last meet to Bay of Bengal. At last, everything, mixture of everything along with tributaries meet to Bay of Bengal, right? Now, one more thing. See, Brahmaputra River has the largest river island in the whole world. See, largest river island. I am talking about river island, not sea island. There are so many sea islands, but Brahmaputra River has the biggest and largest river island called Mazuli. See, Brahmaputra River has the largest island. Mazuli, it is called in the whole world, right? So this is the journey of Brahmaputra and this is the journey of Ganga River. I explained today Ganga River system. I explained today Brahmaputra River system, from where Ganga River originates, from where Brahmaputra originates, and the destination of both the rivers in Bay of Bengal. I hope you have understood through map, through explanation. If you do not remember, watch video twice, thrice, and even in worksheet I have given the information, question answer and short question answer. Especially if you see video, then only you are able to write, otherwise not. So watch video compulsory. If twice, then better. Read, revise. Reading is must, that is my rule. And prepare very well, write worksheet. All the best for reading. Thank you. All right.